we'll find some words that are slightly pronounced a little bit differently, but the meaning is always the same. So just it is important to know this before we start, inshallah. The theme for today's, actually for this year's Tarawih, is khuluq al-Muslim, good manners, what it means to be a Muslim. The next year, inshallah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the life, the theme would be closer to how to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this year, inshallah, every night of Ramadan, we'll talk about some of the qualities of Muslims. What does it mean to be a Muslim? What is Islam? Islam is basically not a club. So when you are a Muslim, you are not a member of a club. Okay? Islam basically means to have a better relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is called ibadat, then a better relationship with human beings, and this is called mu'amalat. A better relationship with the people, and a better relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times you read in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَعْنِ بِاللَّهِ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ وَمَعَ النَّاسِ. So this is emphasized many, many times throughout the Quran. Some people, they don't have this balance. Yeah, they pray five times again a day, they go for Hajj every year, mashallah, they fast every Ramadan. But when it comes to dealing with people, they are not the best. Some people, they are very good, they are very generous, very nice, but they don't pray. They don't fast in Ramadan. So one side of the equation is missing. To be a good Muslim is to have both of them. When you read in the Quran in Surah Al-Fatiha, just like what we were saying before the Salat, the most important surah in the Quran is Surah Al-Fatiha. At the middle of the surah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. Have you ever wondered why we say إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ not إِيَّاكَ أَعْبُدُ إِيَّاكَ أَسْتَعِينُ? So why do you say, you alone we worship and you alone we ask for help? Although you are one, so why are you always talking the plural? Because you are a member of a group. You are a Muslim just like everybody else. Not only are you praying for yourself, you are praying for those standing with you in the line and those who are around the world. Islam always boils down to two things: taqwa and unity among Muslims. Remember your relationship with Allah, the relationship with the people. So taqwa means to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to do the things that please Him and to stay away from the things that displease Him. Unity among Muslims is something we learn from the ibadat. All the ibadat always point you toward unity with other Muslims. Say for example, when you pray by yourself and you pray in jama'ah, which one gives you more rewards? When you pray in jama'ah, unity with other people. When you fast in Ramadan, do you fast anytime you want or you fast with other people? When you go for the Hajj, you go anytime you want. I want to go for Hajj in Rajab, can you do this? No, everybody has to go at the same time. When you give zakat, you don't give zakat to yourself, but the rich will give to the poor. So Islam is always about unity. The problem is we miss this point every single time. So we use ibadat to divide ourselves. I'll give you one example, a very famous example. Every year at the beginning of Ramadan, we always have this big fight. Not only in our communities here, but this is all over the world, especially in the Western countries. We always have this fight, whether we're going to follow this country, we follow calculations, we do this, we do that. It's always this fight. Ramadan tomorrow, Ramadan after tomorrow, it's always this fight. Even if all Muslims in the world agree on the same day to fast, this is the end of it. We always have other fights. Like, are we going to pray Tarawih 8 rak'ah or 22 rak'ah? Big fight. Khalas, we agree that we are going to pray 8 rak'ah. Are we going to finish all Quran in Ramadan or just a few ayat? You know, another big fight. It's always like this. Wherever you go, people are always fighting. Then close to the end of the month, is it tomorrow or the day after tomorrow? A big fight. You know, I remember one time I was in the US and it was the 28th day of Ramadan. They were watching for the moon and the brother came to me and the night there was like 14 hours. It's not like 17 or 18 like here. And the brother literally got on his knees and he said, "Brother, please, make Eid tomorrow. Make Eid tomorrow, I beg you." I said, "Well, I don't have the remote control for the moon in my hands." 10 minutes later, they saw the moon and we told him that he literally was dancing in the street. You know, we always have these fights. I'm going to conclude with this story from Texas gotta get names, okay? Because both of them are gonna shoot me. So anyway, so we had the fight. The first day of Ramadan. Eid al-Adha, 22, a big fight in the masjid. Chairs, baseball clubs, weapons of mass destruction, you name it. Okay? Then one brother, mashallah, he decided to put an end to the fight. What he did, he called 911. And the police came in. The people were fighting, the people were falling down, bleeding on the carpet. Then the police, two policemen came inside and they were walking on the carpet with their shoes on. Now the two groups, the 8 rak'ah group and the 22 rak'ah group, both of them were mad at the police. Hey police, haram, haram, you're walking on the carpet with your shoes. So walking on the carpet with your shoes on is haram, but fighting and bleeding in the masjid is not haram. So please wake up, you know. We have to realize that the bottom line of ibadah is to unite Muslims and not to divide them. We usually, inshallah, every night of Ramadan, we conclude with a question about something in the Quran. You email me the answer, and next day, inshallah, we'll give you a good prize. So the question for today, all the ayat in the Quran are either revealed in Mecca or in Medina. Only one ayah is revealed inside the Kaaba itself. What is this ayah? Why was it revealed inside the Kaaba? If you know the answer, email me before tomorrow, ask at imammustafak@gmail.com. God love you.